Hello everyone, my name is Anya and today I would like to show you how to make this headband or earwarmer, whichever way you prefer to call it. It's very simple pattern, it's just a repeat of two rounds. And the number of stitches, so the diameter of your earwarmer, can be adjusted as the pattern is a repeat of two stitches. So whatever size you would like it, just remember that you need to, in the first round, you need to have even number of stitches. I hope you will enjoy this tutorial and thank you very much for watching. We will start by making foundation chain. So twist your yarn and pull one end through. Insert your hook into the slip knot and we will start making chains. Yarn over, pull through, chain one, yarn over, pull through, chain two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. And carry on making foundation chain. I will make 70 chains plus one, so you will need an even number of chains. And what you need to do when you have the required number of stitches, check if it goes round your head with a little bit of stretching, and then you will know the number of stitches. So anytime it goes round your head with a little bit of stretching, you can stop making your chains. As I said, I will require 71 chains altogether. In the second round, we will be making single crochet. And what we are going to do, we will skip this first single crochet. So we are not counting the chain which is on the hook. This is our first single crochet. And we will skip this chain and we will insert our hook into a second chain, so into this space here, just through one loop. So this is your first chain. We are not working into this first chain, we are working into the second chain. Yarn over, pull through, and yarn over, pull through two loops on your hook. And this will be your first single crochet. We will not count this skipped chain one. Insert your hook into the next stitch, just through the back loop. So in here, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops on your hook. And we will do it again. Insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, and yarn over, pull through two loops. And we will carry on making single crochet into every chain through this back loop only. And at the end, it should give you even number of single crochet. And I will show you how to finish this round. To finish the first round, we will need to make sure that our crochet is flat and facing the same side, and we will need to slip stitch into this first single crochet made. So that is flat and not twisted. And we will slip stitch into first single crochet. So insert the hook into this first single crochet, yarn over, pull through, and pull through the loop on your hook. And we will sew those two ends when we finish our project. We will slip stitch into the next chain. So insert the hook into the next chain, yarn over, pull through, and pull through the loop on your hook. And we can start the next round. To start the next round, we will make chain 2, yarn over, pull through, chain 1, and yarn over, pull through. And we will make beginning 2 double crochet together, but we will skip the next single crochet. Yarn over the hook, skip next single crochet, insert the hook into the second single crochet, yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops. Make chain 1. We'll make 2 single crochet together again, but in the middle we will skip this stitch in the middle. Yarn over the hook, we will insert the hook into the same stitch as the last stitch we worked, so where you have the other 2 double crochet together, so the second part, we will insert the hook into the same space. Yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And we will not finish this double crochet. Yarn over the hook, skip 1 single crochet, insert the hook into the next one. Yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, and pull through 2 loops. You have now 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, and pull through all the loops on your hook. Make chain 1. I will show you again. Yarn over the hook, insert the hook into the same single crochet as the last stitch. Yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And again, yarn over the hook, skip 1 single crochet, insert the hook into the second single crochet, yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through all 3 loops on your hook. Make chain 1. And I will show you one last time. Yarn over the hook, insert the hook into the same stitch as we finished, yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. Yarn over the hook, skip the next single crochet, insert the hook into the second single crochet. Yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 3 loops on your hook. Make chain 1. And carry on making this pattern all the way around, and I will show you how to finish this round. I'm almost at the end of my round. I need to make last 2 double crochet together, skipping 1 stitch in between. So yarn over the hook, insert the hook into the last single crochet we worked, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, yarn over the hook, skip 1 stitch, and insert your hook into the first stitch where you started this round, so into the space here. Yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 3 loops. Make chain 1. And we will slip stitch into this first beginning 2 double crochet together. So into this space here. Yarn over, pull through, and pull through the loop on your hook. We will slip stitch into chain space to start the next round. To start this round, we'll make chain 1, which will not count as a stitch. Into the same chain space, we'll make single crochet. So insert the hook into the space, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops. We'll now make single crochet into every stitch. So insert the hook into this 2 double crochet together. Insert the hook here, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And single crochet into chain space, single crochet intervals, 2 double crochet together, single crochet into the chain space, and single crochet intervals, 2 double crochet together, and again into the chain space, and single crochet into those 2 double crochet together, and carry on all the way around, and at the end slip stitch into this first single crochet made. So not into this chain one, we will not count it as a stitch, but into first single crochet. We'll start this round again by making beginning double crochet, 2 double crochet together. So make chain 2, yarn over the hook, skip 1 single crochet, insert the hook into the next one, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops. Make chain 1. And again, in this round, we will be making 2 double crochet together, but with making a skip, with skipping a stitch in between those 2 double crochet. So yarn over the hook, insert the hook into the same stitch as you finished your work, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops. Yarn over the hook, skip 1 single crochet, insert the hook into the next one. Yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 3 loops. Make chain 1. And carry on making those 2 double crochet together, skipping 1 single crochet in between, and make chain 1 space in between. And again, slip stitch to this first 2 double crochet together. We'll start this round again by making a slip stitch into the next chain space, making chain 1 and single crochet into this chain space. And again, this chain 1 will not count as a stitch. Single crochet into those 2 double crochet together, single crochet into chain space, single crochet in 2 double crochet together, single crochet into a chain space, and carry on all the way around, and at the end slip stitch into first single crochet. From now on, we will continue making last 2 rounds. And I have made 3 more repeats. And please remember that every single time you will need to finish off the round of single crochet. And when you have finished your last round and you have made your last single crochet, please do not slip stitch to the first single crochet. I will show you how to make invisible join. When you have finished your last single crochet, you need to cut your yarn, leaving quite a long tail, and pull this yarn through. We will make invisible join, and I am going to change my hook to a smaller size. And I will use the second single crochet where I started this round. And from the back of the second single crochet, so let me just show you here, I will go with my hook through both loops. And I will pull through this yarn which I cut off. And now I will need to go through the last single crochet, where you have, let me just make sure that you can see it, where you have your last V shape. Insert your hook through the back loop, but from the bottom to the top, and only through the back loop. if I can get it there. And again, pull this yarn through. And it creates a nice V shape. You need to tighten it a little bit so it's the same size as the rest of your V shapes. And you need to weave in this end. And you are almost ready, but please remember that we need to finish off where we started. So we will need to connect this yarn with this part so we do not end up with things like this. So I will show you how to do it now. To finish off the project, I will need to connect both two sides of foundation chain. And what I'm going to do, the end of this yarn, I will put it on the front side of my work. I will insert my hook from the back through the first single crochet, yarn over, and I will pull this yarn through. I will put this yarn again on top of my work. So this is the front side. And this part where it was attached into this last chain, I will insert my hook from the back to the top, yarn over, and I will pull it through. I will fasten this knot here so it looks nice and tidy, and I will weave in this end. And at the end, you will not be able to see where you started your work. Thank you very much for watching.